Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple crane hook in SOLIDWORKS with the help of multiple number of parts. Here we will make crane hook, pulley, and we will combine and we will assemble at the end. I hope you like it. This is a good tutorial for the beginners. So let's see how to make this simple tutorial in SOLIDWORKS. There are multiple number of parts. You can see here we will make each and every part separately and assemble. So let's start to make this simple crane hook in SOLIDWORKS. Now here we will sketch the first part of hook, forge hook. We will select top plane, sketch, draw a circle and keep the diameter 47.625 mm. Okay, and select extruded boards in one direction 50 mm and direction 2 keep 17 mm. Okay. Now select back surface sketch and draw here one more circle and keep the diameter 50 mm. Okay, and extrude it up to 53 mm downward direction. Okay. Now select this plane, choose plane, and I want to create one plane, so select here 187 mm. Okay, now select this face sketch and draw a circle here and keep the diameter 55 mm. Okay, and exit from the sketch. That's it. Now select this plane sketch normal, and here I want to sketch some geometry. So first draw a horizontal line, draw one circle here, keep the diameter 28 mm. Okay. Now select line and connect it . Put here one star mark . Keep angle 16.7 mm. Keep 95 mm. Okay. Now select mirror entity, select these two parts and mirror about this line. Okay. Now choose fillet, keep 14 mm and select this all four corner, three corners. Okay. Now let's assign the distance. The distance from here to this circle 26.03 mm, and the distance from here to origin point 85 mm. Okay, now our geometry is fully defined. Choose trim entity and delete inside lines. Okay. Now exit from the plane. Now select front plane sketch normal, and here I want to sketch some geometry. First draw a horizontal line up to this point. Select this line and make construction geometry. Now choose a line. Go back and draw a radius. Again go back and touch with this line. Exit. Now here we will assign some dimension. 21 mm, 27.5 mm. Now select a line. Connect this line from this point. This is the point of this circle. So select this line and make sure it is horizontal. Now assign the height 80 mm. Okay. Now select this point and this line coincident. Assign the distance 15 mm. Okay. Now our geometry is fully defined. So just exit. Again choose front plane sketch. Select line, draw a line, go back and draw a curve up to like this. Again here go to the point and up to this line. Okay. Now let's assign the distance 24 mm. 27.5 mm. Okay. Now select center line and draw from here to this point. Exit. Select this line and make relation horizontal. Now define the length of this line 175 mm. Okay. And select this point and this point and make relation coincident. Now this second curve also defined. Exit. Now exit from the sketch. Now we will start our first lofted boss base option. First here select this outer circle and this profile, and in path, one path is selected. Choose a second path. See, it is going to take the dimension. Everything keep same as it is. And here make sure merge tangent faces. Okay. We will assign some material to our body. Go to steel, rough steel. We prefer yellowish color. Better keep little yellowish. Okay. That's it. Now again choose front plane, sketch, normal. Draw one center line up to this geometry. Exit. Select center circle and draw one circle. Now assign this gap 15 mm and the diameter 220 mm. Okay. And select this circle and make the construction geometry. Okay. Exit from the sketch. This is for our reference. Now Now we will do one thing. Just select this face sketch and select here convert entities. Now see, it is converted. So just simply exit. Now choose right plane, sketch, normal. And here we will sketch our second geometry. First draw a center line. Make sure this circle is visible. Draw a circle. Keep the diameter 20 mm. Select line. Exit. Choose smart mirror entity and mirror these lines to opposite direction. Choose trim entity and trim these outer lines. Okay. Now let's assign the dimension. (17.49°). (94.3°). Okay. Choose fillet. Keep 10 mm and select these three circles. Select OK. Now select one star and put star here. Exit. Assign smart dimension. (21.99). That's it. Now choose star and place here. Select this star and press select this circle. Choose pierce. Now select this circle and star. Select coincident. Now it is coincide. Okay. Now our geometry is fully defined. Now exit. Now choose front plane, sketch, normal. Now choose center point arc. Select this point and draw is from this. This point and make sure this point and this circle pierce or make coincide. Okay. This is a very important relation. And here also coincide. Okay. Now exit from the sketch. Again choose front plane, sketch, normal. And here again choose center point arc and choose this center and start from this point and connect with this line. Exit. Here also choose this point and this pairs coincide. Okay, now exit from the sketch. Now let's try lofted boss base, and we will select this point as a circle and second this point and select the path. So choose, select open. Okay, select here open. Okay, now see it is open loop selected. Now select second this loop. Now that's it, everything keep normal. Okay, now our first geometry is created. Now again choose this face sketch, select convert entities. Okay, exit. Now select this face sketch normal and draw one circle here. Keep the diameter 50 mm and the distance from origin point make sure 70 mm. Select exit. Now again choose front plane, sketch normal, hide this plane, choose 3-point arc, curve arc, and draw from this point to this point. It is coincident. Here also coincident. Now exit from the sketch. Again choose front plane sketch normal. Now here also select three center point arc and select this center and start from this point and end with this point. Exit. Select this point and this circle, make sure coincident. Okay, and here it is already coincident, so just exit. Now go to swept boss base, lofted boss. Now select both the profiles. Now select the path, select this open loop. Now select path. Okay, now select this second. Now see, select OK. Now the half portion almost done. Now select this face and I want to create one plane. Keep 65 mm. OK. Now select this face sketch, convert entity. Now this circle is converted, simply exit. Now choose front plane sketch normal. Now here select 3-point arc, select this last point and select this and make a curve and assign the radius 145. Okay, now exit. Again choose the same front plane sketch and choose 3-point arc and start from this end and connect it up to this point and make sure. Now select this curve and this curve tangent. This is important relation. Okay. Now this you can little drag it. Now select this plane. Exit. Now select this plane sketch normal and draw a circle. Now just tilt it. Now here we will connect this circle. Select this point and this circle. Coincide. This point and this circle coincide. See, it's connected. It's up to you whatever you want. Just simply exit. Now choose swept lofted boss base. Select this circle and second one delete. Okay, first one selected here, so you also select here, so it will be match. Now select profile, select this profile and this path. Now see the path is selected. Okay, that's it. Now hide this plane, hide this geometry also. Choose fillet, select this face. Okay, 5 mm. So now this is our crane hook is ready. See, now we will create some. Choose fillet, select this end. Okay, now here we will create some threads. Now select this face sketch, select convert entity, this converted, and go to choose helix and spiral. Down, go to downward, here select height and pitch, and height select 50 mm and pitch 5.465 mm. See here reverse direction and angle 270 degrees. Okay, now select front plane, front plane sketch normal, and choose your polygon and select triangle and start from this end point. Okay, now select define the radius, diameter 5.465 mm. Okay, now exit. Select swept cut The profile is selected. Now here we will select the path. So select this line as a path. Okay. See, the threads are created. So this is the threads. Now our hook is ready. See, we created a beautiful hook, crane hook. Now save as, go to desktop, create one folder, crane hook, and first part select hook, save. Now let's move for the next part. Now we will sketch the next part is case 1. Choose top plane. Select center rectangle and draw a rectangle. Keep the width and height 120 mm. Okay. Select circle and draw a circle from midpoint and keep the diameter 50 mm. Okay. And let's extrude it and extrude up to 50 mm. Okay. Now select this face sketch and we want to make some extruded part here. Let's make one center line, connect this end to another end diagonally. Now select circle and choose midpoint and make the diameter 35 mm. Okay. And let's extrude it up to 35 mm. Okay. Now select right plane and just mirror and select this extrude part. Okay. Now it is mirror. Choose fillet. Keep 2 mm and select this end and this end. Okay. Now here select chamfer. Keep 3 mm and select both the end points. Okay. Now see. Now select right plane, sketch, normal. Select center line and draw one center line. Okay. Select circle and draw one circle up to this point. Exit. Now let's assign the distance 6 mm, 20 mm, and keep the diameter 22 mm. Okay. Select a line and or cancel it and select this line, convert it. Trim entity, trim this line, this outer circle and this line. Okay. Select circle, construction geometry and create one vertical line. Okay. Now let's select revolve cut. See, we want to cut a grooves inside. Choose OK. Now you can see it here. Now let's select front plane sketch. Select center line and draw from this center up to origin point. Select circle and draw a circle here. make sure it is coincident with this line, and now let's assign the diameter 3.175 mm. This is the pinhole, and the distance from this line keep 21 mm. Okay, and just mirror this circle about this line. See, okay, and let's extrude cut. Choose here through all both. See here, okay. Now select the whole body and assign the material yellow. Or we will try some other material. Okay. Now save this as a part 2, case 1. Save. Now we will make the next part, case 2. So choose here top plane, center rectangle, and draw one rectangle, and keep the diameter length 110 mm and height also the same 110 mm. Okay. Now select circle and draw a circle and keep the diameter 47.62 mm. Okay, and let's extrude it only up to 20 mm. Okay, now select right plane, sketch, normal, first draw a center line, draw one vertical, then make a horizontal line, select circle and draw circle, make sure this line has a center, and this is the, make sure it is tangent with this line. Now we will assign the distance 6 mm, diameter 22 mm, and the distance from this outer line should be 15 mm. Okay, now select this line and choose convert entities. Select trim entities. Now we will trim this outer part or extra parts. Now again we will select center line and draw one vertical line and make sure it is vertical. Okay, now select revolve cut. See the grooves going to make here. Okay, see it, make always perspective so the ratio will be looks better, and we will assign the material same as previous case 1. Okay, or even you can assign some steel material, it's up to you, but you know I prefer this one. Now save as part 3 case 2. Okay, now we will create some balls which is float inside this cutout, so let's do it. Now let's make the ball for bearing case. So here select front plane, select circle and draw a circle, keep the diameter 15.875 mm. Okay, select line and connect just one end to another end, to just split the circle, choose trim and delete half circle. Okay, now select revolve boss, select this line as axis. Okay, now our sphere or ball is ready. We will assign some chrome finish. See, it looks a very nice steel ball. Even you can assign some other material, so it looks better. Okay, this is better. Now save as part number 4 ball. Now here let's make the fifth part of crane hook, side support. So let's start. Choose your front plane, sketch, center line, and draw 1, 2 center lines, and let me select here circle, one small and the last one. Let's define. First, I'll define this one, 380 millimeter, 140 millimeter, 85 millimeter, 80 millimeter. Or let's keep the same 85 millimeter, 80 millimeter, and this one make a small 36 millimeter. Let's make the distance also 170 millimeter. Now this all fully defined. Let's select your line and select this circle and draw up to here. Go back this point and it will automatically convert into arc. Okay, then comes to this. Let's create some relation. Select line and circle and make relation tangent. That's it. Here also tangent. Check this tangent, or better to draw tangent relation already here, and this circle and line tangent relation. That's it. Now let's define this. Keep radius 100 millimeter and select one more time this circle center. Choose center and the center of this circle coincide. Okay, this is what we want. Choose mirror entity and select these three lines, mirror about this vertical line. Okay, that's fine. Choose again circle, draw here one more and here one more. Let's define this 30 millimeter. Diameter 30 millimeter. One more circle at the end, and let me define this one 35 millimeter. Okay, now choose your line and we want to connect this one, so select this up to here, exit, select here mirror entity and select this line and mirror against this vertical line. Okay, now let me define the gap 30 millimeter. That's it. Okay, now no need to delete this internal line, we will adjust in extruded portion. So this is the our perfect dimension, this is the our design. So I'll choose extruded boss base. Now here we have to select, so I'll choose this one, this one, and this one. Only left this inside circles. Make 14 millimeter thickness, and keep end condition mid plane. It's better for this. Select OK. That's it. Now choose fillet 100 millimeter. Select this end, and here select these two ends 100 millimeter. Again, choose fillet and 50 millimeter for this two. Delete this face, select here OK. Now this is the our side support is ready. Now let's define some color. Let me choose dark red. OK. Now I want to write something here. Select this face, this sketch, and let me choose 3-point arc. Okay. Now select this line, arc, and make construction purpose. Even you can little adjust, it's up to you. I'll select this line text, write something pulley 351 WTS. This is the number. Let me adjust this one. See, it is reverse direction, so choose here flip vertical. That's it. Now this is also here one option, you will find flip horizontal. Now that's it. Now let me choose center align. Okay. Now uncheck this use document font, click font. I'll choose bold and let me choose 20 millimeter. Okay. That's fine. It looks this WTS, make WTS. It's a simple standard, any kind of standard, and select extruded cut, and I'll choose the thickness 2 millimeter. Okay, so the impression will comes here. See, now let me save this one. Select save, make this part number 5 side support. Now we want to make middle support, so how we will do this one? Just simply select this 1, 2, 3 and delete, and this one select edit feature, and here delete the last or clear. I'll choose 1, 2, 3, only 3, and this bottom one just leave as it is. Keep everything same mid plane 14 millimeter end condition. Okay, now see, this is the mid one. So how you will save? Just don't save it, just simply select save as part number 6 and choose this one middle support. That's it. Now here let's make the next part, crane pulley. So I'll choose this right plane, select here line, draw a line, just make sure it is passes through origin point. Convert an into arc, leave it, choose again line. Select here 3-point arc. Exit. Now select these two lines and make relation first collinear, then equal. Two relations we did here. Okay. And select the origin point and this line and make relation midpoint. See, now this is in midpoint. Let me define this one. 45 millimeter base and 100 millimeter height. And select, just adjust this one. Millimeter, and this one 22 millimeter. Okay, now this is fully defined. Even though, let's make 3 millimeter. Okay, now go to feature and select revolve boss base. Here it is asking axis of revolution, so I'll choose this bottom line. See, once you choose the bottom line, it goes around. Keep end condition blind and keep 360 degrees so that it will make perfect curve, perfect circle. Okay, that's it. Now select this back surface sketch, and here we want to create a hole. Select circle and draw one circle. A smart dimension and define it 36 millimeter, because our hole goes for 36 millimeter. Now select extruded cut, and here keep end condition through all so that we will create a perfect hole. Okay. Default, just go to appearance, metal, steel and brushed. This is looks fine and better. Now let's save this one. Part number 7, pulley. Now we will make one more small pulley. So how we will do this one? We will just edit this one. Edit sketch. Normal. This one we will keep everything as it is. This one only we will define 40 millimeter. Now look. Look. And this circle also we need to reduce. So how we will do this one? Just expand this extruded cut, select sketch 2, edit sketch, and this 36 make 30 millimeter. Exit. Now see, so this is the our second pulley. So select save as 8. Even you can write a small pulley. Save. Let's make some washers. Here the next part is washer. So let's make some simple washer. Choose front plane, sketch. Choose here circle and draw two circles from origin. 1, 2. Choose a smart dimension and let's keep outer 150 millimeter and inner 136 millimeter. Extruded boss base. Keep mid plane and make the thickness only 4 millimeter. Select OK. And select here any chrome finish. Save this one. Part number 9, washer 1. Edit this inside one, keep 30 millimeter and this outer one 35 millimeter. Exit. See, save as 10 washer 2. This is just increase this one 39 millimeter because it's too small. Now save it. Now let's start to make the assembly. Now let's make the assembly of crane hook. So select new and choose assembly here. Now this is the our assembly window. We will browse our first part, crane hook. Adjust the screen plane. Okay, now insert another component case. Now choose mat, select inside hole and this hole. Okay, now select this circle and this face. Clear. Select this and select, choose tangent. Okay, make sure it is rotating. Okay, now insert balls. Now just adjust the ball inside the cage. Now just select mat, select the ball and select this inside grooves and choose tangent. Okay, now we want to make number of balls. So here we will select circular pattern, select clear. Here select ball and for axis select this axis. And we want more number of balls. Okay, 13 number of balls are enough. Okay, now see here this much balls are here. Now it is rotating. Now let's browse the another part case. First rotate this case. Okay, choose mat, select this both the face, select coincident. Okay, select this hole and this, choose clear it. Mat. We will delete previous relation. Now we will select this bolt and this hole. Concentric relation first. Okay. Now let's bring down. Select this ball and this inside and make relation tangent. Okay, now we make one more relation, this parallel. Okay, now see the boy, it is rotating towards the crane hook. Now go to design library. This is your design library. Just select ISO, choose nut, select hexagon nut, and select this hexagon nut style 1 ISO 402. And choose here M48. Select here schematic, double chamfer, select OK, cancel. Now just rotate. OK, now move it. Okay, now select this circle mat and select this circle coincident. Okay, actually that was concentric, this face and this face. Okay, so now our nut is fixed here. Now here let's add some more parts. Browse and choose side support and middle support. This is side support and this is middle support. Let me rotate this one. Mat, select this, make concentric relation. Okay, select this face and backside. See here, make relation coincident. Okay, now select control key and copy. Now just try to rotate this part. Okay, choose mat, clear, select this face and this circle, make relation concentric, drag this one out and select these two faces for coincident relation, select OK. That's fine. Let's make one more relation. Select this circle and this circle. Make concentric relation. The same here, this one and this one. Concentric relation. Now just go to advanced mat, choose your width. Select these two faces, outer faces. And the comes to middle one. See, it will shift it to middle position. Select OK. Now the mid one is fixed here. Now we will fix some nut bolt here. So just go to design library, toolbox, isometric. Here you will find bolt and screws. Now first we will go for hexagon head. Okay, then heavy hexagon flange head, just drag it to this one. This one is smaller, so let me choose some other one. we choose your hexagon head. Okay, so let me choose heavy. Hexagon cap screw and select this smaller one and select this face. Choose your length M30 and keep the length 180 millimeter. Now see, select OK. Now it is asking to choose one more, so I'll again come here and select this face. First select the hole and face and it will automatically comes. OK, again let's drop the same thing. But this time we need to increase 36 millimeter and keep the length 180 millimeter. That's this our standard thread. We will not show any thread. Okay, select okay. Now that's it. Now let's fix here some nut. Choose your nut, hexagon nut. And here you'll find, see, hexagon jam nut. Just drag and first this bow and this face. Millimeter. Select washer face. Simplified. Okay. Now again drop to this circle and this face 30 millimeter. See, it is automatically selected from here. If you want to change, just change, but our bolt is 30, so choose M30. Okay, it is asking one more, so select this face. Okay, just try to move. Now the bolt and everything fixed. Now see, now let's bring some washer one. Then pulley. Choose mat. Select this pin and this face. Make relation coincident, concentric. Select this face, coincident. Now here we need to make multiple number of, so just select, copy. Here also we need let's do the same thing. Okay, and let me finish this one also. Okay, this face and this face. Okay, now let's fix the concentric relation. Select this outer face and outer face of washer. Okay, Now see, it is perfectly fixed. Cancel. Press Ctrl key and copy. Ctrl key, select and drag. Or even you can directly insert component. Select mat. Select bolt and hole. Concentric relation. Okay. The back face and this back face. Clear. Again, let me select concentric relation already added. So, select this face and washer face. Coincident relation, cancel. Now that's it. We created one small bearing also, pulley also. So let's browse this one. Small one, and let's browse this washer too. Press Control. Okay, let me define concentric relation. Select this face. Okay. Press Control key and copy this. Just drag it. So keep as it is. So we will create one relation, concentric relation. Okay. This face, choose your mat, and this face. Make coincident relation. Circle and pin a bolt. This face, coincident relation. Okay. Now see, the our pulley is almost ready. See, just do one thing, save this pulley, this one, crane hook assembly. See, just adjust it because it is rotating along with axis. See, so I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video. If you have any comment, just write down below. I'll try to answer each and every question. Even let me select this one, right click and fixed. Now just rotate, right click this one and float. Now once you click float, it will float. See, okay, this is the perfect position. So don't forget to share and like our videos, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.